Let me start with you. Is this going too far?
Is the letter going too far? Absolutely. It's an absurd claim. Apparently, Congressman Issa has a short memory, because not only were these tactics started during the Bush administration, but executive privilege has been around for three decades. It was actually started during the Reagan administration. So the Obama administration is absolutely consistent with current law, and they've handed over 7,600 documents over the last 14 months. So this is an unfortunate partisan fishing expedition when Congress has a lot more important important things to be focused on
Kate,
right now.
And in fact, I do have a copy here of the Democratic responses on the committee to this entire affair, and they say, yes, this is a partisan political fishing expedition. Do you worry that this will hurt Republicans?
No, I think that the Obama administration has reached way too far. And by the way, I could have written the talking points. It's always Bush's fault, even though Fast and Furious is a program that took place between 2009 and 2011 during the Obama administration. But what the chairman is saying, what ISA is saying, is the Obama administration can't have it both ways. They have said that they knew nothing about Attorney General Holder's response, that February 4th letter that he has finally, months later, acknowledged was false.
Right.
The Obama administration said, we didn't know anything about it. Now they are claiming executive privilege, which means they knew something about it. So they have to make a decision here. Did they know something about it? Come clean, present the documents, or they didn't know anything about it. But if they're just assessing executive privilege in order to obstruct justice or obstruct the investigation, that is a huge problem.
You know, Jen, I want to play a soundbite from the House, former House Speaker, Nancy Pelosi, Minority Leader. Here it is.
These very same people are holding him in contempt, are part of a nationwide scheme to suppress the vote. They are closely allied with those who are suffocating the system. Unlimited special interest, secret money, and they are poisoning the debate. They are poisoning the debate with that money.
Jen, you buy that? Really? Come on, seriously?
Look, I do want to touch on two things that Kate said. One is,
no, just
this
answer my
did
question.
Start
do you buy that,
either.
Jen? Come on.
Look, I'm not even sure. I think there are many issues with the there are many issues with what's happening with campaign finance right now. That's absolutely true.
Come on.
And I do think Speaker Pelosi has a very strong point there. But we're talking here about Fast and Furious, and we're talking about this absurd debate that's happening in Congress right now when we know a million people could lose construction jobs over the next couple of months. We know that student loan rates are about to double. Why aren't we focusing on that and talking about that?
You have this really perplexed look on your face.
Because a Border Patrol agent was killed because of a botched federal program, and the Congress is just trying to get some answers about why it happened. What is this ridiculous cover-up? I thought that this was supposed to be the most transparent administration in history. And then for Nancy Pelosi to come in and throw race baiting into it and try to continue this administration's policy of dividing Americans is absurd. Let's just come clean with the truth. Stop pouring in documents that don't matter. Put forward the documents that were requested. The president has said that he wants to be open and honest. So be open and honest and stop claiming this privilege that does not apply if he didn't have anything to do with it.
All right.
The documents are not related to
Kate Obenshain.
The president
not material
has no
to the
right
you.
To claim executive privilege.
You guys
if the president
can continue
was
this conversation after I leave, okay?
Well, thank
you.
You, Greg. Thanks for having us
Jen
on.
Jen and Kate, good to see you. Thanks.